Hey, what's up, you guys? Craft Farms here. Welcome back to Waverly, Kentucky, where I am once again forgetting to drop the air seeder. Oh, boy. Well, we are here. We are going to be finishing up our oats today and actually our March field work. In general, and unfortunately we are not quite gonna have enough seed to be able to finish this field, so we're gonna have to figure out a way to set this so that we can actually dump into it and not get our truck stuck again. So I'm thinking that we will probably just set it so that the auger is on that grass separating the two fields here. That's kind of going to be the plan. Might not even have enough to get down to the other end. Oh boy. It's going to be close. Two bushels left. Are we gonna make it? Nope. Not quite. It's gonna be close. So close. Okay. So, I'm gonna pull this right up here. Let's get that auger out so we can see where exactly we need to be. Because I have not closed the game to be able to... Oh, and we lost our load. Okay, well. Oh well. We'll just reload it. So yeah, I have not taken out that wheel script yet, so we're just going to have to make do for the time being. We lost like half a truckload there, but that's okay. Okay, a little over half a truck. That'll work for now. Let's get on over
to a field.
Oh, excuse me. I do like that you can actually hear it shifting. It's kind of neat. There we are. Now we can get her up there easily. Let's get topped back up. Seed we are definitely going through at a pretty high rate. It is. All right. that works then. We're just gonna shut that guy down right there so we can hop back in here and get moving again. Okay. Let's get this thing finished off. Let the drill sit for a couple days. Definitely not a whole lot left on this field. Two little passes and we are good to go. We're just hitting 56 acres, which isn't too bad. Not bad at all for 38 minutes into the day. Nice to be able to get that much done in half an hour in real life. Really knock out some acres in a day then. I think last spring and fall, when we were seeding, I think we were getting between 100 and 200 done a day. I think we were able to do more in a day in last spring because this fall we had so many issues with fertilizer and all sorts of stuff going on with our drill when we were putting winter wheat in. So we had a lot of stopping and starting. By the time we got done seeding winter wheat, me and the boss man both wanted to rip every hair out of our heads. We were so frustrated with the air seeder. Alright, let's get this big beast on home. And we'll get it just pulled up. I guess we'll pull it up where we usually park the air seeder. And just let her sit for now. We'll jump in our 7810 and get some rolling done. Boy, that tractor is moving. He is definitely cruising, that is for sure. So we'll just swing this around and pull it up right next to the corn planter there. And then when we're ready to go on soybeans, we can just pull it right on up. Let's make sure that we're not going to hit our corn planter or anything like that. Perfect. Alright, let's grab our truck here. We'll get this guy home. We'll pull it up under the auger and get it topped off. And with these two trucks, our two straight trucks here, if we have leftover seed and fertilizer, I'm not going to really worry about it. Well, a couple tractors coming. Because that's pretty much all that these trucks are going to be used for. So, I know once we are ready to get cows and start making feed, we are going to have to pick us up some pallet forks for our 7430. And get us some totes of mineral feed. So get this guy backed on under here and get him filling. And we'll grab this guy. Perfect. Alright, let's get this guy unfolded. Oh, and we do need to adjust this. We got that seated. Perfect. All right, drop our roller on down. Oh, that's quite the rolled texture. It's kind of nice, actually. That. Very well done. I'm definitely liking this map more and more as I go. Definitely interested to see what we have for crop textures when we start seeing some crops popping up. You can definitely tell the difference between rolled and not rolled really easy with this texture here. Which is good to know. So then in the future, if we buy a field and there's no stubble on it, that at least we'll be able to fairly easily tell where we did and did not go. Alright, let's get this back on and set us up some GPS here. Our auto save. There we go. Wanted to make sure that thing got fully set in the ground. Oop, too far. There we are. This is quite a nice little roller. Some a little different than starting out with the Mandaco that I pretty much always start out with. Which eventually we'll probably upgrade to the Mandaco, but this at least gives us something different to start off with. Textures are really neat. I really like that. It's always neat to see maps have different things in them, you know, different setups and in terms of textures anyways. This map has so many paintable ground textures, things like that. Those always are nice additions to any map. So it's always rather nice to see them. Portion of this to go. Perfect. that folded up. And that is done. Let's head on over to our next one. This tractor is going to get a lot of use on it as well, with rolling, spreading, spraying, running auger. This is probably going to be our auger tractor as well. So she's going to get her they're going to have her work cut out for. Flip that quite yet. That's for our next field. All right, away we go. Not sure if I left enough overlap to pick up that edge further down. I don't think so, though. Anyway. So I'm just gonna shift this course, or the line over as we need. Should be good there. Might miss a couple of little bits along that edge, but that's alright. Missing right there. Get us lined up for our next pass around. Roller definitely has some good flex to it. Give it that. That's another thing I do really like on this map here, is it's got a good variety in terrain. It's not too flat and it's not mountains. A good sized field, though. Should be able to get decent amount of straw off of it. I love how the vehicles just come spawning and flying in there. Should line up perfectly down on the end. Worked out great. Squared off. There we go. This thing is dirty. Tractor's barely got anything on it yet. But this thing is what's rolling across the ground, digging in dirt, so kind of to be expected. Alright, well, I think off camera I will just finish up the rolling, just because it's kind of a, rolling is, to me anyway, is kind of boring, just going over it non-stop, you know, there's no stopping to fill, nothing like that, so I'm going to finish the rolling off camera. And I'll get us moved up to April, and then we'll have a lot to do. We'll have our soybeans and corn to plant and roll, and then we'll have to spray our two oats fields here and get the weeds taken care of. We're actually missing a little bit there. Huh. I'll have to fix that. But anyway, so I will get that taken care of off camera and get us ready to move on with our spring work. So thanks everybody for watching. Hope y'all enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to smash that thumbs up button. If you are new to the channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button if you like what you see. Make sure you turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. And as always, folks, we'll catch y'all in the next one.